sing.
जय प्रभुपा जय प्रभुपा प्रभुपा जय प्रभुपा जय श्रील प्रभुपा जय प्रभुपा जय जय प्रभुपाद जय प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद जय प्रभुपाद जय श्रील प्रभुपाद जय प्रभुपाद जय 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 प्रभुपाद 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 जय जय प्रभुपाद जय प्रभुपाद जय जय प्रभुपाद 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 जय प्रभुपाद जय प्रभुपाद Shri Guru Charana Padmam Kebala Bhakati Sadma 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 Bandho Mui Sabadhana Mate Bandho Mui Bandhamui Sabadhana Mate Bandhamui Sabadhana Jahar Prasade Bhai Ebhavatariya Jai Jahar Prasade Krishna prapti haya jaha haite Krishna prapti haya jaha Krishna prapti haya jaha haite Krishna prapti haya jaha Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chitete Kariya Aikya Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chitete Kariya Aikya ना करी हमने आशा आर ना करी हमने आर ना करी हमने आशा आर ना करी हमने श्री गुरु चरण रती ऐसे उत्तम गति श्री गुरु चरण जे प्रसादे पूरे सर्व आशा जे प्रसादे जे प्रसादे पूरे सर्व आशा जे प्रसादे पूरे सर्व चक्षु दान दिल जे जन्मे जन्मे प्रभु से अक्षु चक्षु दान दिल जे जन्मे जन्मे प्रभु से अक्षु दान दिल जे दिव्य ज्ञान हृदय प्रकाशित दिव्य ज्ञान दिव्य ज्ञान हृदय प्रकाशित दिव्य ज्ञान प्रेम भक्ति जहा हते अविद्या विनाश जाते प्रेम भक्ति जहा प्रेम भक्ति जहा हते अविद्या विनाश जाते प्रेम भक्ति जहा वेदे गाय जहार चरित वेदे गाय वेदे गाय जहार चरित वेदे गाय श्री गौर करुणा सिंधु अधम जनेर बंधो से गुर करुणा सिंधु श्री गुर करुणा सिंधु अधम जनेर बंधो से गुर का लोकनाथ लोके रजवाना लोकनाथ लोके रजवाना लोकनाथ हा हा प्रभु करो दया देह मोरे पद छाया हा प्रभु करो दया प्रभु कर दया देह मोरे पद छाया हा प्रभु कर दया एवे जास गो सूत्र भुवाना एवे जास गो सूत्र भुवाना श्रीला प्रभु पाद पतित पावाना श्रीला प्रभु पाद पतित पा जया जया प्रभुपाद 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 जया प्रभुपाद जया प्रभु जया जया प्रभुपाद 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 जया प्रभुपाद नमः ॐ विष्णु पदाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी नीति नाम नाम वैष्णो नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशोत्तारिणे नमस्ते जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद जय श्री कृष्ण जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद जय श्री कृष्ण हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 Krishna, Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, 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 Hare 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 Krishna, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama, राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा हरे राम राम हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा हरे हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 निताई गौरांग निताई गौरांग निताई गौरांग Nitai Gaurango Gaura Hare Nitai Gaurango Gaura Hare Gaura 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 Hare Gaura Gaura Krishna Balaram Jaya Krishna Balaram Krishna Balaram Krishna Balaram Jaya Vrindavan Dham Krishna Balaram Jaya Jai Jagannath Jai Jagannath Jai Shyam Sundar Jai Jagannath Jai Shyam Sundar Jai Baladev जय सुभद्रा जय जय बलदेव जय सुभद्रा जय जय राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ राधे जय जय राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ राधे जय राधे जय राधे जय जय राधे जय श्री राधे जय राधे Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ramo, Hare Ramo, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare. Jaya Jaya Prabhupad 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 Jaya Prabhupad Jaya Prabhupad Nitai Gaura Haribol 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 Gaura Haribol Gaura Nitai Gaura Haribol 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 Gaura Haribol
Jayam Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribhrajaka Acharya
His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ji Maharaj Ki Jai. ISKCON B.V.T. Sanstapak Acharya Srila Prabhupada Ji Maharaj Ki Jai. Jagat Guru Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Srila Prabhupada Ji Maharaj Ki Jai. Ananda Koti Vaishnava Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai. Srila Prabhupada Guru Puja Ki Jai. Sri Sri Gauru Nityananda Prabhu Ki Jai. Sri Sri Radha Gopinath Ji Ki Jai. Lalita Visakha Ki Jai. Sri Sri Jagannath Baldev Subhadra Maharani Ki Jai. Shambhit Vaishnava Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai. Nitai Gaur Premanande. All glories to assembled devotees, all glories to assembled devotees, all glories to assembled devotees, all glories to Guru Gurang Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna.
Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. 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 Gopi Jana Ballabha Giribar Dhari. Jaya Gopi Jana Ballabha. Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Yashoda Nandana Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Yashoda Nandana Yamuna Tira Bana Chari. Yamuna Tira Bana Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jai Radha. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Jaya Prabhupada. Jaya Jaya Gurudev, 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 Jaya Gurudev, Jaya Jaya Gurudev. Jayam Vishnu Pad Paramahansa Parivrajika Charya. His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ji Maharaj Ki Jai, Ananda Koti Vaishnava Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai, Sri Sri Radha Gopinath Ji Ki Jai, Gaur Nityananda Prabhu Ki Jai, Sambit Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai, Granthara Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari. Onga Jnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakhyuran Millitam Yena Tasmei Sri Gurave Namam Namo Ang Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesh Sunyavadi Pashyatya Deshatarine He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesh Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Brindavaneswari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Bancha Kalpataru Vyasya Kripa Sindhu Bhyaye Vacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo 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 Mahabhadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratvise Nama Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Shri Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Hare Krishna Srimad Bhagavatam, 9th canto, chapter 23. So we have to read from 1 up to 20. All these slokas, okay. Sri Sukha Uvacha. This is not mentioning here. From verse 1, I will continue up to 20. Yeah. Ato sabhanarascakhyo parishnuschatrayo sutaha sabhanaran kalanar srunjayan stat sutastataha. Sukadeva Goswami said, Anu, the fourth son of Jajati had three sons named Subhanara, Chakhyu and Prasenu. O king, from Subhanara came a son named Kalanara and from Kalanara came a son, Srunjaya. Janmejaya stasya putro mahasalo mahamanaha usinarastitikhyuscha mahamanascha atmajo. From Srunjaya came a son named Janmajaya, and from Janmajaya came Mahasala, even from Mahasala, Mahamana, and from Mahamana, two sons named Usinara and Titikyu. All the names you can see, especially in 9th canto, you can find many devotees' names. So why Sukadeva Goswami just narrating their names, their dynasties? Why the dynasty? Why just mentioning in 9th canto? 9th canto is character. There is 10 character of Srimad Bhagavatam. In 9th canto is belongs to Isa Katha. Atasarga visargascha sthana poshana utaya manuntara Isa Katha nirodha mukti asraya. 9th canto belongs to Isa Katha. Isha Katha means this is, how can I say, stories, leelas about Lord. But mostly you can find in 9th canto, only you can see devotees' names, kings' names. Why? We can find its answer within these verses.
Sibi Barha Krumi Dakhya Chatwaro Sinaratma Jaha Brusadharva Sudirascha Bhadrake Kaya Atmavan Sives Chatwara Evansi Stitikhyascha Rusadratha Tatohe Motho Sutapa Bali Sutapo So Bhavat. The four son of Usinara were Sibi, Bara, Krimi and Dakhya. And from Sibi again come four son named Brusabhadra, Sudhira, Madra, and Atmatattvavit Kekaya. The son of Tittiki was Rusadratha, and from Rusadratha came Homa, and from Homa Sutapa, and from Sutapa Bali. This Bali is different. Anga Banga Kalingadya Srutpunrudra Sangitaha Jagire Dirgato Dirgatomaso Bale Khetra Mahikitaha. By the semen of Dirgatama in the wife of Bali, the emperor of world six sons took birth name Anga Banga Kalinga Sumha, Pundra and Odra. Chakruhu sunamna bisayan sadiman prach sadiman prachyakham prachyakangschate khalopanangato jagye tasmadi virathastataha. These six sons, headed by Anga, later became the king of six states in the eastern side of India. Anga, Banga, Kalinga, and Orissa is called Odra.
this word is there, Odra. Later it became Orissa. Some Sanskrit name is there. Which one belongs to Anga, which one belongs to Kali. And before Odisha's name was also Kalinga. One king was ruling, his name was Kalinga.
Suta dharma ratho jasya yagnya chitra ratho prajaha roma padai tekhyasta tasmei dasaratha sakha santa sokanya prayachat rusya srunga uvahya jam deva varsati yangrama aninya harini sutam natya sangita vadyatrei vibhra malinga narhane saturagyan patastasya patyasya nirupyasti marut Marutvate prajamadata dasarat jenalebya prajah prajah chaturangaro mapadat pruthulakhyastu tat sutaha. From Diviratha come a son named Dharmaratha, and his son was Chitraratha, who was celebrated as Romapada. And Romapada, however, was without issue, and therefore his friend Maharaj Dasaratha gave his own daughter named Santa. And Romapada accepted her as his daughter. And therefore, after she married Rushyasringa, when the demigods from the heavenly planet fell to shower rain, Rushyasringa was appointed the priest of performing a sacrifice. After being brought from the forest by the allurement of prostitute who danced stages theatrical performance accompanied by the music and embraced and worshipped him. After Rushyasringa came, the rain fell. Thereafter, Rushyasringa performed a son-giving sacrifice on behalf of Maharaj Dasarath, who had no issue, and then Maharaj Dasarath had son. From Romapad, by the mercy of Rushyasringa, Chaturanga was born, and from Chaturanga came Pruthulakhya. This was a nice story. How Rushyasringa, only Vaishnavs, Brahmins, they are not satisfied with Rushyasringa. Be careful, especially in our tradition. We are, therefore, after Mangalarati, we are paying obeisances to all Vaishnavs. Bancha, Kalva, Taru, Vyascha. Even when we meet other Vaishnavas, we are also paying obeisances. Because we don't know how he devoted to Krishna, how he devoted to parampara, how he devoted to spiritual paraphernalia. So we have to give respect to Brahman and Vaishnavas. This is our, we can say this is our foundation. What happened in case of Romapad? Some Brahmins, they are disappointed with Romapad. This is our real dharma, this is our real duty to please Vaishnavas. We have no capacity to please Supreme Personality of Godhead. Because our consciousness is always material consciousness. We are in a material body. Body, mind, senses, they have many demands. We are always hankering to fulfill all these demands. Where our consciousness? How can we please Supreme Personality of Godhead? So, our duty to please Prabhupada, to Acharyas, Paramparas, Vaishnavas, this is our real duty. Yasya prasadat bhagavat prasado, yasya prasadena gati kutupi. There is no other way, there is no other destiny for us. Romapada, some Vaishnavas, some Brahmins, they are displeased with Romapada. And they left Romapada's kingdom. You see how there is a connection between demigod, Vaishnavas, and Supreme Personality of Godhead. Yasya prasade na gati kutupi. If a Vaishnav, a Brahman dissatisfied, no one can give you any sort of boon. You can't get any sort of perfection in your life. That is just like we are Vaishnavas. If in this life we can't please our spiritual master, parampara and acharyas, our life is just like, we can say like ghost.
You know, ghosts, they have no shelter. Sometimes some ghosts are, they have no shelter. If they will sit down over any tree, even the tree fell down. They have no shelter. They are creating such a abominable works. No one giving shelter. So if sadhu, guru, Vaishnavas, they are displeased with us, then we have no shelter. Na gati kutu upi. Therefore, every day we are praying, Haha Prabhu Karadaya, Deha More Padachaya. This word is very important. Padachaya. We want shelter. We are always, our life is always suffering, we see. We are always suffering. Either suffering by mind or senses, from others, by demigods. Always we are suffering. And we want some shelter. No one can give you shelter. Father, mother, money, government, no one can give you a shelter. They are not giving a shelter. In name of shelter, they are giving problems. In name of shelter, they are giving only problems. Only they can give shelter. Aha Prabhu kara daya deho mure pada chaya. Away just ghusuk tribhuvan. I will just glorify your glories all over the three world. And because some Vaishnavas, some Brahmans displeased with Rompad, no rain happened within the kingdom of Rompad. And without rain, one moral instructor saying one nice things. Okay, without rain, a king can maintain his kingdom. But without a real king, without a real Brahman, you cannot maintain this world. If rain not happen in this year, government may help you. But without a proper government and without proper Brahman Vaishnavas, this whole world is nothing. Only problems will come. So when rain not happen, Rompad became worried and consulted with other Vaishnavas. This is spiritual life. When problems come, we have no power to overcome the problems. And our effort to overcome the problems means we are creating another problems. Just like monkey. When monkey, this is the nature of monkey. Monkey want to solve some problem, rather he create many problems. This is monkey business. When we are small, our teacher always used to say, why you are like monkey? Always jumping. You are not sitting in one place. You are not studying. That means we are creating problems. When problem coming, we have no power to solve these problems. Better just take surrender of acharyas. Pray to them. Consult with them. And we have to follow their principles. So Rompad was very serious, a student and a devotee, nice devotee. He consulted with the Brahmans, and Brahman says, only if Rushyasrunga came, because this is Jajati Maharaj's dynasty, and in this dynasty Jadu will come. Jajati's son is Jadu, and in Jadu dynasty Krishna will come. And only Rushyasrunga, if you will come from forest to your kingdom, just by Rishyasrunga reach in your kingdom, rain will happen. You see the power of Vaishnavas. They're so dedicated. They have such a power. Even if we please a Vaishnavas, then we can please whole demigods. We are not worshipping demigods. Sometimes Karmi people, they are criticizing in India. Only you are worshipping Krishna, but not worshipping Shiva, not worshipping Brahma, Durga. Because in India, many festivals. But when you are worshipping Vaishnavas, Vishnu and Vaishnavas, we are Vaishnavas. Vaishnavas, it does not mean we are only worshipping Vishnu. No. We are worshipping Vishnu as well as Vaishnavas. Therefore, we are Vaishnavas. And when you are worshipping Vaishnavas, all demigods will please. Devata bandhava santa santa atma aham eva tuhu. In 11th canto, Oila Gita. We have no other, how can you say, demigods. Who is our demigod? Karmi people, they have demigod like Shiva, Durga, Kali. Who is our demigod? Our god is Jagannath, Krishna, but who is our demigods? Vaishnavas. Vaishnavas. Like you see, Karmi people, they are worshipping demigods to fulfill their desires. And we are worshipping Vaishnavas and we are paying obeisances. Bancha Kalpataru Vyasya Kripa Sindhu. You see, Bancha Kalpataru, how can desire tree, huh? Desire tree can fulfill your desire. But desire tree will not kick out your material desires. Desire tree have no power. But Vaishnava is such a desire tree, he can fulfill your desire and kick out your material desire and give such a, how can I say, valuable treasure, Krishna Prem. Krishna Prem. This, not material, how can I say, Vaishnava not only fulfill your material desire, but spiritual desire. Vaishnavas are demigods. Only Ramapad want try to please Rishyasringa. Some Brahmins, he consulted with the Brahmins. Brahmins inform, you just go. Or in any way, you bring Rishyasringa because he was a brahmachari. Very austere brahmachari. And usually Rishyasringa staying with his father. If you want to become brahmachari, you have to stay with your guru, superiors. Actually, this individual mentality is very danger in spiritual life. Independent, individual. This is right, this is wrong. All these decisions coming from our mind. What is wrong, what is right, what is good, what is bad, we don't know. The individual mentality is very harmful in spiritual life. Therefore, we are always consulting our gurus, superiors, Vaishnavas. And Rishyasringa was severe, austere brahmachari. He was always staying with his father. His father before was a brahmachari also. Very austere brahmachari. He was always within the cave. Always in daytime, never came out. Always within the cave. And within like in Mangalarti time, he just came out from the cave and taking bath within the river. And you know what? He usually took prasadam. His prasadam was neem tree. Neem tree, some barks. How can you say? Neem leaves, neem only. Eating something and immediately just going inside the cab and chanting. We can't do it. It's not possible. But once, it little late in the morning when he was taking bath, at that time, Apsara Urvasi went. And just by seeing Urvasi, he loses brahmachari life, celibacy. And it fell down in the water. Simmons fell down in the water. And downstream, one deer was there. And deer at that time drinking water. And this deer drink this Simmons and become pregnant. And this deer usually staying nearby the Rishyasringa's father ashram. Then deer become pregnant and birth a child, give a child. This child is looks like, how can I say, Rishyasringa. Totally human. But in his head, you can find horns like deer. But his father took a bow. My life was spoiled. Because whole life I perform austerity only by seeing a woman, my life spoil. So this is my vow, I will make my son as the best brahmachari in this world. And he always keeping his son under his control. Yeah, if you want to become brahmachari, direct supervision is required. You have to stay under direct supervision of guru. How to eat, how to sleep, how to do service, how to chant, everything is required. Because if you misuse time, and if you're not disciplined, within 1 minute or within 1 second, mind will drag you. Everywhere maya, and mind have a, how can you say, mind, he had a long association with maya. Father always look after his son, Rishyasringa. But one day, here Romapadi is crying because Brahman said, you bring Rishyasringa to your kingdom. But who will go? Everyone is very fearful for Rishyasringa's father, because Rishyasringa's father, he already told, if someone come, some old man come, specially to this ashram, then I will curse. Everyone knows, even Ramapad knows. But Ramapad, King Ramapad declared, I will give enough Lakshmi, enough money, gold, if someone can bring Ramapad, Rishyasringa, then one prostitute, and this is mentioned here. Yeah. When the demigods from the heaven planet, however, without his, Prabhupada mentioning here, yes, Rishyasringa was appointed the priest for performing sacrifice after being brought from the forest by the allurement of prostitute. And Rishyasringa also don't know anything like sweet rice, dal, sabji, no. Within the forest only some fruits. He never took sweets, nothing else. But the prostitute, she promised to Rompad, if you give enough money, I can bring. And she took nice, how can you say, sweets. With her, she bought nice sweets, so many ghee, sweets, many things she bought. And within the boat, she went. And within the river, within the boat, she was staying and looking after Rishyasringa, where Rishyasringa is staying. And one day, his father just going inside the forest. She came to know, prostitute came to know. And she went. And little talk with, start to laugh. And talk with Rishyasringa. Who are you? Where you come from? And Rishyasringa, he was thinking, he's also a saintly person. He's also a brahmachari. Throughout his life, Rishyasringa never saw who is a man. He don't know who is a man, who is man. He was thinking, this prostitute also, he's a saintly person, he's a sadhu. And he's asking, where is your ashram? He said, oh, my ashram. You see, this is the power of maya. Just by seeing, just by tucking something. And the prostitute embraced and gave some sweets. First time, Rishyasringa in his life just eats sweets. And thinking, oh, my father is not giving all these things. I am within the forest only eating fruits. But in her ashram, so nice fruits. And she's talking so nicely. Why I'll stay here?
better I will stay in his ashram. Anyhow, I have to stay in any ashram. But he don't know she is a prostitute. And she is a woman. He don't know. Then father came and prostitute just went and staying within the river, within the boat and remarking. Because her mission is to bring back Rushyasringa to Rumpa. But when father returned, he remarked. His son's attention immediately remarked, oh, maybe some woman came. And asked to his son, Rishyasringa, someone came? He said, yes, father. Another Rushi came. She was prostitute, but he don't know. Rishyasringa thinking everyone is saintly person. Everyone is Rishi. Everyone is sannyasi. How she looks like? And Rishyasringa describe everything. And father understand. My mission failed. Just by singing. And sweet singing. And she gives some sweets. Everything finished. His whole consciousness, his whole mind was stay with this prostitute. Then after a few days, this prostitute remarked, no one is there. Again came. And he invited Rishyasringa. Why are you staying here? You come to our ashram. Nice place. Sweet rice is there. Everything is there. Rishyasringa thought, okay, I have to stay in any ashram. Let's go. Then he came with the first teacher. And when they came, just with Jai Gopinath, Jai Jagannath, Baldev Subhadra Gaur. When they just reach in the country of Romapada, a rain start happen. Then at that time, Vasishtha and all Vishwamitra, all saintly person informed to Dasarath. Dasarath, you had no son, but this is the only chance. If you invite Rishyasringa and perform some yajna, who can fulfill your desires? Who can? Without Vaishnav, without a pure Vaishnav, no one can fulfill our desires. We are like beggars. How? Maybe many, how can you say, heroes. Huh? You have many rupees in bank. But actually we are beggars. Why? Because we have many desires. When desires hunting you, attacking you are like a beggar. Who can fulfill all our desires? Who can kick out even our material desires? Who can fulfill our spiritual desires? Only a pure devotees. No one. Even demigods have no power. Because see, every day from morning to evening, in one day, how many desires is coming? So who can fulfill? And how can we kick out all these desires? And all saintly persons inform to Dasarath. Dasarath, you have spiritual desire. You want a nice son for Ayodhya. But this is the only chance. Because Rishyasringa, when he came to Ramapad, married to Ramapad's daughter. Actually, this was Dasarath's daughter, Shanta. Then Dasarath Maharaj invited. This was in Ramayana. And something is in Bhagavatam. This is Jajati Maharaj's dynasty. Then Rishyasringa went to Ayodhya and perform some yajna. Then Charu came. Then Ram, Lakshman, Bharat and Shatrughan came. Why we are hearing their names? Not all the stories, even their names, Sukadeva Goswami mentioning in front of Parikshit Maharaj. Only how many days? 7 days. And 9th canto, 10th canto, he started in 4th days. End of 3rd days, he was discussing 9th canto. And all these names, only by hearing devotee's name, by hearing Vaishnav's name, we can achieve all sort of perfection only by uttering and hearing. Here is proof. Bruhadratho bruhat karma bruhat bhanuschatat sutaha adhyada bruhat manastat tasmat jayadratha udavruta. The son of Pruthulakhya, we are bruhat, bruhadratha, bruhat karma and bruhat bhanu. From the eldest bruhadratha come a son named Bruhatmana, and from Bruhatmana, Bruhatmana came a son named Jayadratha.
Vijayastasya samvrutvah tato dhruti rajayatam tato dhruta vratastasya statakarma dhiratastataha.
The son of Jayadratha, by the womb of his wife, Sambhuti was Vijaya, and from Vijaya, Dhruti was born. From Dhruti came Bruhatbrata, and from Bruhatbrata, Satkarma, and from Satkarma, Adhiratha.
Jo so gangatare kridan, manjusantargatam sisum, kruntyapaviddhakaninam, manapatyokaron sutam.
While playing on the bank of the Gangas, Adhiratha found a baby warped up in the basket. The baby had been left by Kunti because he was born before she was married. Because Adhiratha had no son, he raised this baby as his son. This son was later known as Karna. You see how such a great history was within the ninth canto. Therefore, always everyone knows Karna as Suta Putra, son of Suta. And what is his father's name? Here it is mentioned, Adhiratha. Adhiratha's son.
Bruhatsena Sutastasya Karnasya Jagati Pate Druhyoscha Tanayo Babhru Setustasyatmajastataha.
O king, the only son of Karna was Bruhatsena. Karna's only one son, Bruhatsena. Druhyu, the third son of Jajati, Druhu, the third son of Jajati, had a son named Babhru, and the son of Babhru was known as Setu.
Arabdhastasya gandharastasya dharmastato dhrutah dhrutasya durmadostasmat prachetap prachate sahasatam.
The son of Setu was Arabdha. Arabdha's son was Gandhara, and Gandhara's son was Dharma, Dharma's son was Dhruta, Dhruta's son was Durmada, and Durmada's son was Pracheta, who had 100 sons. You know about story about Prachetas. And where Prachetas came, this was not mentioned in fourth canto, but you can find here how it connected, how Prachetas performing austerity. And why Vishnu came? Why he came? Why he gave boons to Prachetas? Not for his austerity. When Vishnu appeared, he became so pleased with Prachetas because 100 brothers, they are performing austerity in one place. And with one intention. Yeah, we can please only Vishnu and Vaishnavas by our mood. Our mood. When our mood to please Vishnu and Vaishnavas, and we have no other desire than to please Guru and Krishna. Like we are sons. You see, we are grandsons of Prabhupada. What grandson wants, grandfather wants. But even your father wants. If you have you have 5 brothers, your father's desire, 5 brothers should stay in one place. They should take care of my property. They should take care of my properties. They should not quarrel. They should not fight. They should not disagree. Then father became happy. All acharyas, they have same mood. Forget this idea. In Kali Yuga, we can perform such severe austerity like Rishi Srunga, like Prachetas, like Dhruv Maharaj, like Prahlad Maharaj. We can't do it. But we can please Acharyas by performing, following this principle, by our mood, when we cooperate each other. Therefore, Prabhupada told to our spiritual master, Gurudev, cooperate and tolerate. If you want to continue Krishna consciousness and if you want to continue my mission, then cooperate and tolerate. Prabhupada told to Gurudev. Then we can fledge Vaishnavas. Unless we cooperate each other and unless we tolerate, we cannot serve. We cannot serve. Even to maintain your family, husband, wife, you have to cooperate each other. And this is Krishna's family. In your family, you can stop cooking, you can go to restaurant. But in Krishna's family, you cannot stop anything. You can't stop it. This is Nitya Leela. So just remark how much cooperation require to please Guru and Krishna. We have to tolerate. How can we cooperate? Unless we tolerate, we cannot cooperate. This is the problem. We have mood to cooperate with the other, but we have no tolerance power. Unless we develop tolerance power, we cannot cooperate. And without do so, we cannot speak spiritual master because we have to continue this mission, seva. Prabhupada's duty is there. We have to serve. How can we serve? How can we serve? Unless you develop our vision, our mood, we cannot serve. Very difficult. We are discussing on that. Prachetas. Why Vishnu so pleased with Prachetas? Vishnu came and to give boon and inform to Prachetas. I am very pleased with your mood. All your brothers have same mood. Same mood. Like Chatur Kumar, you see, four sons, they have same mood. Bharat Maharaj, nine sons, Navajogendra, they have same mood. And our Vaishnavas, Sat Goswamis, they have same mood. How to please Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? And we have to develop such mood. How to please Prabhupada? How to please Acharyas? Then mrachadhipatayo bhuvan udichim disamasritaha turvasvascha sutavarne varne bhagato bhanuman. The Prachetas, the son of Pracheta, occupied the northern side of India, which was devoid of Vedic civilization, and became the king there. Jajati's second son was Turvasu. The son of Turvasu was Barni, and the son of Barni was Bharga, and the son of Bharga was Bhanuma. Tribhanustat suto syapi karandama udaradhi marutastat suto putra putra paurava anvabhut. The son of Hanuman was Tribhanu and his son was magnanimous Karandama. And Karandama's son was Maruta, and he had no son, and who's therefore adopted son of the Puru dynasty, Maharaj Dushmanta, as his son. Then this is the conclusion of 18 and 19. Why we are hearing only their names, names, names? His son is like that, his son is like that. Even we don't know. You know about your father, huh? You know about a grandfather. Then, who is your, how can I say, grandfather's father? We don't know. Who is his father? We don't know. Even we don't want to inquire it. Who is our grandfather's father's father? But why Sukhdeva Goswami? Because by uttering their name, by remembering Vaishnavas, This is the result. What is its result? You just hear from these verses. Dusmantah sa punarbhejeh suvangsa rajya kamukaha jajati jashta putrasya yaduvangsa narasabha varnayami mahapunyam sarva papaharam runam yaduvangsa naraha srutva sarve papa pramuchyate. Only by hearing all these Vaishnav's name, just translation, Prabhupada translating. Maharaj Dushmanta, despairing to occupy the throne, returning from his original dynasty, the Puru dynasty, even though he had accepted Maruta as his father, O Maharaj Parikit, let me now describe the dynasty of Jadu, the eldest son of Maharaj Jajati. This description is supremely pious. Supremely pious. You can see, when sometimes people coming to our temple, after Arati, we are giving, how can we say, Jai Dhuni, Prem Dhuni. Jayang Vishnu Bhad Paramahansa Parivraja Gacharya. His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada Ji Maharaj. Then we are uttering Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's name. Then we are uttering Gorkhisthas Babaji. They are looking towards face. Why they are uttering so many sadhus' name? Even previous acharyas, like before days, they are uttering everyone's name. Like Baldev Vidyabhaswan, Viswanachakra Thakur, Sadhguru Swami's, everyone's name. You know, in India, so many saints before Gaudiya Vaishnavas, they are uttering everyone's name. Every deity's name. Govinda, Gopinatha, Madan Mohan, Shamsundar, Bank Bihari, this one, that one, that one. And all Acharya's name. Why? Remembering. Remembering previous Acharyas and their contribution, their glories. And even therefore in our calendar, Vaishnava calendar, you can see appearance and disappearance of all Acharyas. Our Gurudev used to say, to not reminding previous Acharyas in their appearance and disappearance day and not reminding their contributions, this is injustice. This is injustice. We have to always remind about previous acharyas. What is their contributions? Even you can go to India, you can see entering, you want to enter someone's house in front of their, before, now I don't know, now you see dog's picture. But before, they keeping their father's picture. In India, you go to enter to their house, you can see in their walls, father, grandfather. Even sometimes before days, they have no cameras. Even in art, they keeping their grandfathers. Because they want to remind their father, even their karmis. But we don't want to remind. Every day, when we are paying obeisance to Vaishnavas, Banchakal Pataru, not only for present, Vaishnavas. Past, present, and future. Hayache habene jata Mahaprabhur das Sabara charana bande dante dhari ghas. Devakinandas Thakur mentioning. Even those, in future, those Vaishnavas will come. For them now I am paying obeisances. And those Vaishnavas already entered to Nitya Lila, for them. When we are paying obeisances, Banchakalpaturu, for all. Even in future, many pure Vaishnavas will come. For them, now, we are paying obeisances. And je deshe vase gaurange rajan urdhava uhaya vande sabara charan. I am paying obeisances to all Vaishnavas. Like now when we are paying obeisances to Vaishnavas in Europe. Huh? But actually, Devaganandana is mentioning, jedese bose gorangere jan. In any countries, even in India, Europe, UK, America, when you are paying obeisances in temple or in your house, you are paying obeisances. We have to remind all Vaishnavas within three wide. We are paying obeisance to them. Why? Therefore, Prabhupada is mentioning here, this description is supremely pious. Pious means it will give you strength, spiritual strength. To remind acharyas means you are healthy. You are reminding acharyas teachings, contributions, that means you are spiritually healthy. Therefore, you see, when we are chanting, in end of our mala, every bit, we are reminding acharyas. We are uttering Prabhupada's name. Why? If you want to become spiritual healthy, then you have to always remind acharyas. Then you can lead your spiritual. Otherwise, you may chanting, you may performing some seva, but your condition will be like a bamboo. You see in India, bamboos. Here is bamboo. Bamboo. Like woods. No. Okay, woods. Some insects within the woods. Some insects in India, within the woods, in the bamboo, you can recognize them. They are inside and finishing everything. How can I say? Everything, yeah. Inner side. Only looks good. And you just slightly move here and there, it will fall down. We may chant, we may serve, whatever we may do. But unless we remind acharyas, unless we pray every day, our condition will be like that. Our anarthas, maya, is just like small insects. Looks like small. He will eat all the essences of our life. Yes. Lastly, we can't get any test in spiritual life. This is the strength. You see, even in karmi life, your political leaders, they are proud for their country. This is Europe. Someone is saying, oh, this is France, this is Belgium. The political leaders, they are working for their country. They are proud for their country. Our pride? What is our pride? For ourselves. We are developing pride for ourselves. I am great. Even see, karmi people, they are proud for their country, for their nation, for their community. And we are developing, this is actually real pride in Vaishnavism. This is called Abhiman. Not false ego, this is real ego. When you develop real ego for acharyas, for paramparas, this is real ego. And with this ego only we can lead our spiritual life. Without ego you cannot do anything. Some officer, he's thinking, I am a big officer, therefore he's working. A Brahman, he's thinking, I am a Brahman, therefore he's worshipping. If Brahman thinks, no, I am a drunkard, he cannot worship. If Brahman, he will think, I am a Sudra, he cannot worship. And you are thinking, I am a devotee, therefore you are a devotee. When you think, oh no, I am not a devotee, I cannot. Then you can give up this path. But how can continue the real ego? This is the real strength coming to continue the spiritual life comes from real ego. What is real ego? This is real ego. I am coming in this parampara, Brahma Madhya Gaudiya Sampradaya. And our acharyas, Sad Goswamis, Narottamdas Thakur, Shyamananda Prabhu, Jiva Goswamis, and up to Prabhupada. What is their contributions? How great? Every day we have to remind. Then you think you are wealthy, healthy. But actually, when we develop pride for our qualities, for our sevas, this is false ego. Therefore, Prabhupada mentioning here, why we are hearing? This description is supremely pious and it is vanquish the reaction of simple activities in human society. Human society, what to speak about us? If we utter or we describe their names, their leelas, the simple reactions will go out. And simple by hearing these descriptions, one is free from all sinful reactions. Simple by hearing the descriptions, one is free from all sinful reactions. Therefore, Sukadeva Goswami mentioning their names. Because directly or indirectly, they are connected to Krishna. Because they are coming in the dynasty. You just consider about Hiranyakasipu. You consider about Hiranyakasipu. He was a devotee? His son was a devotee. But indirectly, if you consider his situation or his standard, indirectly he was Krishna consciousness every day because he was always thinking about Prahlad. He want Prahlad should be king. Because Prahlad don't follow his instructions, therefore he was angry. But indirectly if you think, he was always thinking about Prahlad. How Prahlad should come under my control? He should follow me because I want Prahlad should become king. So if Hiranyakasipu always thinking about his son who is a devotee, he is not in Krishna consciousness. Therefore you see, when we are worshipping Nrisingadev, we are worshipping Prahlad. You are not worshipping Hiranyakasipu? Yeah, because Nrisingadev carried Hiranyakasipu. We are worshipping Nrisingadev, but simultaneously Hiranyakasipu is there. Only connected with his son, who is a devotee. And we are uttering his name, Hiranyakasipu Tanubhrungam. You see, we are uttering his name. Namaste Narasinghaya Prahlada Lada Daini. Then Hiranyakasipu Purvakhya. Why? You cannot kick him out from his son, from Lord. Because indirectly he was connected. If he indirectly connected, he got such a position. But we want to connect it directly. And we want to please Krishna. Please Vishnu and Vaishnavas. Therefore, every day we have to remind. Actually, when we are paying obeisances, Bancha Kalpataru, as far as possible, we have to remind all Vaishnavas. And we have to pay obeisance to all Vaishnavas, to Guru, Guru Parampara, Acharyas. Please give me strength. Some strength required to continue spiritual life. Strength required anyhow. And spiritual strength, not material strength. You know this song? Echay Gosai Jabe Braje Kailabas Radha Krishna Nitya Lila Karila Prakas Echay Gosai Jar Muitara Das Tasavara Padarenu Mura Pancha Gras. In India, nowadays it is different. Before, people going to different holy places, they bring, some sands, dusts from holy places. Why? Why we bring Brajadhula? We bring, when we are going to Vrindavan, you bring some, Why you bring some dust? How many Vaishnavas? Krishna's dust pit is there and Vaishnavs. After, before in India, after they took bath, after they performing some puja or before puja, they took this dust and put over his head. I want to purify myself with the dust of all Vaishnavs. And this is actually this is our food, spiritual food. Spiritual food. Remind the Vaishnavs their instructions, thinking about them and begging mercy from all previous acharyas. This is actually strength. These are spiritual food. Without that, we will become weak. And another, in that verse, in that song, another verse is there.
अच्छय गोसाई जार मोई तार दास तास बार पदरेणो मोर पंच ग्रास जा हिते विघ्न नासि अभिष्ट पुराण.
इन दैट वर्स इफ यू रिमाइंड वैष्णव व्हाट इज इट्स रिजल्ट लाइक प्रभुपाद मेंशनिंग हियर दिस डिस्क्रिप्शन इज सुप्रीमली पायस. And same thing is mentioned in Narottam Das Thakur. Jaha haite big, we have many impediments in our life. We are not facing problems. Many problems. And only we can conquer or we can cross over all the impediments only by reminding acharyas. Vaishnavs. Hari, Guru and Vaishnavs. These are like shields. Shields, you know. My English is not good. I am not so qualified. Shields. Before fighting, a hero, heroes, soldiers, before they are going to fight, they using shields. Shields. Dress. Huh? Yeah, like that. To protect themselves. Yeah. They cover their body. Like now, bulletproof jackets. Nowadays, you see, prime ministers, big men, bulletproof jackets. Before soldiers, they are wearing like that. And for our spiritual protection, this is. Maya will not shoot you. What is that? Hari, Guru, and Vaishnavs. Gurudev, all Vaishnavs, and Hari, Krishna. Three. The three things. And always we have to remind. Always we have to remind. And among three things, one inner is there. Like you may wear a bulletproof jacket, but to protect your chest, something special thing is required. For head, for chest. Because all are sensitive places. And the inner, how can I say? For your inner protection, first is Guru. Protect your chest, Guru. Then another covering, Vaishnavs, then Hari. Like three coverings, three protections. And we have to remind always, Jaha haite vighna nasa abhishta puran. We can kick out all our impediments, we can conquer all our impediments, and abhishta puran, whatever our desire, only by the reminding acharyas. Echaya gosai. Why Prabhupada adopting these systems? You can, usually, I was always mentioning in Bhagavad Katha, you can't find in any parampara, they're keeping all their parampara pictures. They're keeping parampara pictures in the how can you say, in their halls, temple halls. Huh? You can't find they're keeping their parampara pictures near the deities. Prabhupada knows, he was Acharya. He's Mahaprabhu's man. He's Saktyavesa avatar. He knows. He's Sadgoswami's paramparas. This is strength. But we are not focusing. Therefore, Sukadeva Goswami mentioning. Okay. Now it is time. Tomorrow maybe we'll just discuss this verse. Still today we'll start it.
Jatravatirna Bhagavan, Jatravatirna Paramatma Narakrutihi, Jado Sahasrajit Krushta,
Nalori Puriti Srutaha Chatvara Sunavastatra Satajit Prathamatmajah Mahahayore Renuhayo Hayascheti Tatsutaha. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, translation by Sri Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, the Super Soul, in the heart of all living entities, descended in his original form as a human being in the dynasty or family of Jadu. And Jadu had four sons, namely Satrajit, Krushta, Nala, and Ripu. Of these four, the eldest Sahasrajit had a son named Satajit, who had three sons named Mahahaya, Renuhaya, and Hayaya. Purport. Big purport. Okay, tomorrow we'll discuss again this verse. Is okay? Or today we can read it, eh? Now it is time already. As confirmed in Srimad Bhagavatam 1 to 11, Badanti Tattva Vidam, Tattvam Jad Gyanam Advayam, Brahmeti Parmetmeti, Bhagavan Iti Sabdyate. Learned transcendentalist who knows the absolute truth, call these non-dual substances Brahman, Paramatma or Bhagavan. The majority of transcendentalists understand only the impersonal Brahma or localized Paramatma. For the personality of Godhead is very difficult to understand. As Lord says in Bhagavad Gita 7.3, Manusyanam sahasre sukasci jatade siddhaye, yatatam yapi siddhanam kascit mangbeti tattvataha. Out of many thousand among men, one man endeavor for perfection. And of those who have achieved perfection, hardly one knows me in truth. The yogis and gyanis, that is, the mystic yogis and the impersonalist can understand the absolute truth as impersonal or localized. But all those such realized souls are above ordinary human beings, they cannot understand how the supreme absolute truth can be a person. Prabhupada mentioned it so nicely. They are not ordinary men like Mayavadis. They know so many shastras in India. They can defeat us in one sentence. They can defeat us. They are very scholar in Sanskrit. They are not ordinary men, but they have no power to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead as a person. Prabhupada mentioned it. They cannot understand how the Supreme Absolute Truth can be a person. They can't understand. Therefore, it is said that out of many siddhas, the souls who had already realized the absolute truth, one may understand Krishna, who exactly resembles a human being, Narakriti. This human form was explained by Krishna himself after he manifested Virat Rupa. The Virat Rupa is not the original form of Lord. The Lord's original form is Dibhuja Shyam Sundara, Murali Dhara. The Lord with two hands playing a flute, Yangsam Sundaram Achintam Guna Surupam. The Lord's forms are proof of his inconceivable qualities. Although the Lord maintains innumerable universe within the period of his breath, He is dressed with a form exactly like a human being. That does not mean, however, that he is a human being. This is his original form. But because he looks like a human being, those with a poor fund of knowledge consider him an ordinary man. The Lord says, Abhujanandi mangmuda manusimtan vasritam param bhavam janantu mama bhutam aishwaram. Fools, Derived me when I descend in a human form. They does not know my transcendental nature, my supreme dominion over all that be. 9.11. By the Lord's Parambhavam or transcendental nature, he is the all pervading Paramatma living in the core of heart of all living entities, yet he looks like a human being. Mayavada philosophy says that the Lord is originally impersonal, but assume a human form and many other form when he descended. Actually, however, he is originally like a human being. And the impersonal Brahma consists of the ray of his body. Jasya prahoto jagadanda koti. Tomorrow we may discuss about how even for scholars it is very difficult to understand how Krishna assumed this form as 200 form. And repeatedly Prabhupada mentioning from Bhagavad Gita, from Bhagavatam. Ordinary, actually, we are not, we cannot say we are, still we are not ordinary human beings. Even we have poor fund of knowledge. But if you know Krishna is Supreme Personality of God, as you are worshipping Krishna, you are chanting Krishna with faith, this is the most important thing. If you have unflinching faith, even you are poor fund of knowledge, Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. He can fulfill my desire. Then you are not an ordinary human being. Yes, tomorrow we may discuss more. Thank you. Yes, if you have some question, not this time. Yeah. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Shri Shri Gaurinityanand Prabhu ki jai, Radha Gopinath Lalita Visakha ki jai, Jagannath Baldev Subhadra Maharani ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Granthara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Sambit Vaishnava Bhakta Vrinda ki jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol, Hare Krishna. Gopal, Gopal, Gopal.